Hi, welcome back in the workshop. This is my new Rockler pack rack that I won as second prize in the WorldyGig Wars. I'll tell you more about this later. We were left last time with filling up the wall on the backside of the shop. And that was a bit, well, difficult. We didn't take much pictures of it. So I'll have to describe you a bit how I did it. It took about 10 days sorting out the stones, finding the stones' faces, combining them, you know, the big ones with the little ones, and the worst part, of course, is getting them up there. Many times a bucket and some rope would do the job, but others had to be lifted up on the shoulders. I can tell you now that it's not easy carrying 50 kilograms on your shoulders up on a ladder. But in the end, it's all about result, and to me, it looks pretty good. I placed an 11 centimeter pipe at one point right through the wall. At the time, I just thought that would be a good idea. And now I'm happy I did that, because a future dust collection would need such a thing. It would be almost impossible to get a hole in the 70 centimeter thick wall now. It gives you a feeling of satisfaction looking at a job done. But, well, that's just temporarily. Realizing there's a front wall, and especially the rest of the old walls that almost are 7 meters high. Now, with the back wall finished and being in the cement mood, I decided that it was time to restore the big wall that divides the workshop on the street side and our B&B apartment on the backside. This wall is the biggest remaining part of the old ruin, almost 7 meters high, and it's still standing after 200 years, although it's just stacked with stones and some clay. It will be there forever if there is no rainwater splashing on top of it. As soon as these kinds of walls stand alone without being protected by a roof, they get very vulnerable. The biggest challenge to get the buildings on both sides connected with a movable but rain-tight fixture. Movable because the old wall will set itself every time there's a big storm or an earthquake. And yes, the last couple of 100 years there were minor earthquakes here in Portugal. And in 1755, the Great Lisbon earthquake, it was on Saturday, the 1st of November, combined with fires and a tsunami, as we call it now, almost totally destroyed Lisbon and the adjoining areas. They estimate that the Lisbon earthquake had a range about 8.5 or 9 on the magnitude scale. And the death toll in the area was between 50 and 100,000 people, making it one of the deadliest earthquakes in history. But if you look at it, well, all historic buildings like castles, aqueducts, they still stand tall. These walls have the ability to move with shocks, to bend under heavy pressure. Our ruin did well during the last earthquake in 1948. The downside of it is these walls are hard to combine with rigid materials. My job was to make sure the top of the wall was able to stand all the heavy rainfall we get in the winter months. Now, I did it with a layer of steel supported concrete, which is only connected with some steel plugs every half meter or so into the wall, so the wall can expand and shrink underneath the slab of concrete. On top of that, there is a thick layer of bitumen. It took about 8 coats. And the gap between the wall and the roof of the apartment on the back is filled with a special kind of bitumen, like a kind of silicon kit, but, well, it's something special. It came in 1 meter long bars, 5 by 5 centimeters, and you have to melt it with a blowtorch. It's a strange stuff. All the gaps were filled with a mixture of cement, the old clay, and some water-resistant fluid. As you can imagine, there are no tools for that, so it took 8 sets of gloves and some sore fingers to get the job done. The good thing of all this is I got over my fears of heights, being days on top of that wall. The big wall was repaired, but I needed to put steel beams for the roof on the right wall and on the left wall. The problem is that the street is so narrow that it would put the roof on in a conventional way. It would stick out of the wall at least 15 centimeters. And it's not that I had nightmares about the farmer from next door getting through the street with his tractor and hitting the roof, but he scraped the wall before, so I had to come up with a solution. I just went out to see how problems like this were solved in the narrow streets of Tomar and found out that the roofs are just halfway on the wall, with the gutter built into the roof. This seems to be a solution people came up with in the 30s of the last century, when the first little trucks had to be able to deliver the goods into town. Before that, it was never been a problem, because the biggest transport around were wagons and horses. Well, the world has changed a lot in 8 decades. Because the wall being 70 centimeters thick, it wasn't a problem to integrate that solution to my build. The only downside is that the hose pipe is going inside the building at the top and outside the building at the bottom again, because it can't be on the street side. And no, we don't have a sewer system over here. Having completed the structural things, I asked some friends to help me with one of the few things I couldn't do alone, or just with the help of my wife, and that was putting up the 7-meter-long roof plates. It's nice to find out that after a few years of living in a country, you make friends that are on your doorstep as soon as you ask them. Going down the pictures of these builds made me realize that it's a great way to grow a gray beard. It took just 2 hours to put all plates up, cutting them to the right length and screwing them tight. The dinner and the drinks after the job is just a different story. The roof was on, time to get the workshop to be closed up to keep the rain and the wind out. Easier said than done though, because we were still aiming on that authentic look. There used to be a door on the roadside, not very practical, because this street is so narrow and safety reasons were also to take in consideration. First job was to fill that gap on the street side. We've decided to convert it into a window, using old beams from the ruin itself. At the same time, we had to lead the drain from the gutters through the inside and the outside of the wall again. Because of the narrow road, it would be almost impossible to put it on the outside, because somebody could hit it with his car mirror or something. To be able to work in the evenings, we decided to get some lights in before moving onto the doors and windows. Before we could decide on how to go forward, we got some unexpected helping hands from family members. That our house happens to be a nice place to spend your holidays could have something to do with it. The last bigger job was making the carport, so we did. What we didn't know at that time was that a few months later a hurricane would pass our village and would lift up that whole carport, including its concrete pillars and the rocks where it was mounted on. Luckily, we could repair everything and did not have to buy new materials for it. This time we put some steel brackets inside the concrete all the way down into the ground. Now, sometimes it doesn't feel all that smart working with wood. Every time there's bushfire, you think, well, why am I making doors and windows out of wood and not out of steel or aluminium? But as a woodworker, you'll get over that thought quickly if you walk around the lumberyard and search for some wood to make the doors. The smell of sawdust is just too familiar, and no other material can compete with that. It's not just the dangers living among all these trees during the 3 months rain-free and hot period. This landscape is one of the reasons we moved to Portugal. Most of our free days are spent outdoors. We don't have to travel. We are living in the middle of a beautiful holiday destination. But work has to be done, so the double doors on the front are made out of pine, bought about a year before the start of the project. Well, yes, at the lumber yard they call it seco, which means as much as dry, but we've got some experience now. We just made it all simple. No locks, no handles, no key to open the front doors, just 3 sliding pieces of hardwood to close up the door safely. They will only be used when bigger items need to go in or out the workshop. The windows are reused. They came out of an old house that sadly had to move for a new one. Well, not many Portuguese take on restoration. They just knock the old buildings down and start from scratch with cheap bricks and lots of concrete. The back door is made after an example of a traditional Portuguese door. Big asymmetric horizontal dovetails keep everything together. Well, and then we came to a new floor in the workshop. I'm going to show you that in part 4. Now, this is the Rockler clamp rack that we won during the Whirly Gig Wars 2013 with our Whirly Gig, the pros and cons of hitchhiking. And, well, we were voted second place. We were very happy with that. And a few weeks ago, the mailman brought this rack. Now, it was about 30 kilos, so we had to, well, he had to get it up the stairs to our front door, and I had to take it down again because I needed it in the workshop. But I made a video of how I made it together with my little friend, and show you that. well, you need all the help you can get. But well, it's nice. It's very strong. There's one downside to it. It won't come together as described in the papers with it, because the nuts on the inside are so close together. There is no way you can use some kind of tool to close them up. So I just have to put a few on the outside. It's strange, but it doesn't work if you want to have them all flush. Somehow they should have made the holes further apart or something, I don't know. But for the rest, it's strong. It came with these little brackets so I can make myself a shelf in it, here or there. Can put one in the bottom, can put one on top. I don't know what I'm gonna do. It could also be a very big tripod for a video camera, I don't know. So we're happy with our clamp rack, and we're gonna use it well here in the workshop. I would tell you, go out and do some woodworking. It's a nice way to spend your time. And see you all next time.